Friends, today I've got a connector we can use to join 3D printed parts, so let's get cracking. Friends, today's project starts with a bit.ly or a link in the description. It is bit.ly/zdp, snap, and press enter. This takes us to a fantastic method created by ZDP189. Of course, it's set to copy in Tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Make sure you give a reaction before you copy in Tinker. Alright, so when you do copy and tinker, you get an exact copy of the project that was created by ZDP189. There are notes in it. Note, we print it in this orientation. We have got two different connectors to make this sphere come together, and then we use this connector to snap it in. This was the hole that was used to cut in here so that these could snap together. I am printing these right now so you can see how they work. This is just a glimpse of what they would look like when put together. So ZDP leaves these set to copy and tinker and allows us to mess with them and learn how they're built. I'm going to do Control D and move this up here. I'm going to do Control D again. So I have a second copy I can play with in a moment. So here's what I want you to see. If we ungroup, you can see he's got a cool technique for curving these edges. If you ungroup again, you can dig in and see just how it was built. This is great for if you want to learn the skills or modify it. So I want to trace this shape, or if you want to trace any shape with the brand new sketch tool, I want you to understand that the sketch tool is size 20 by 20. So I'm dropping it right in that grid square. Once it sets down, you can see this part is over here, not really in a useful location. So we're simply going to hit finish sketch. Now if I grab those two, choose L for align, pick the sketch tool, if I tell it center and center, now when I double click sketch to edit, it is exactly in the center. Now to draw this, we can see right here that these points line up, but the next point does not. You can go over to the snap grid and you can shut that to off. Now you still can't do the whole shape because it is a curve, but we've got curves available. If you hit number 2 or click this button, you get a bezier curve. You can click on the location and you can twist the handles to get it to the exact shape you want. Now I want to go back to straight right here, so I'm going to hit the number 1, press enter, and bingo, I can trace this shape almost exactly just like this. If you want your grid back on, you can set it to 0.1 so you can get even closer to the exact spots and just follow the shape all the way around. Notice the measurements sometimes get in the way. So that's why I just zoomed in so I could get to that spot easier. Notice I missed this. I'll fix it in a moment. That cannot get close with 0.1, so I'm going to just switch to off. I'm going to do number 2 so that this is a curve. Remember, ZDP had to cut this. Now, because of the Bezier Curve tool, I can simply bend it, click, hold, and twist to get the shape I want. I'm going to switch back to number 1. I'm also going to turn on my 0.1 grid just because I like to be able to snap the straight lines and just continue those steps all the way around our part. So that is our shape using the brand new sketch tool. Now you remember there were a couple points that weren't great. We can double click and you can remove points with this tool. Just remember, after you've removed them, make sure you switch to this tool. Otherwise you'll accidentally delete it. If I zoom in over here, I also missed this one. I can now simply grab it and put it right where I wanted. You can also click on these and adjust the handles. There's my curve tool. Once again, if this is in your way, the measurement, you simply zoom in a little further to get it exactly the way you want. Notice you can stretch this out to find the exact location for how you want your pin to be. Of course, once you've got it the way you want, you can hit finish sketch, and bingo, you've got your own version of this that you can use and modify for the rest of your projects. You can use that same technique to trace the hole as we use this elsewhere. So, of course, these are solid parts. I saw a question the other day where a person wanted to snap together hollow spheres. So check this out. I have been building. I have got a hollow sphere here. I have cut off the tops just so it prints quicker and it lets you see the mechanism. We are using the exact same pins. If I hit T for transparent, so I put this halfway inside it so they fit. I'll show you how that works with an ungroup. There you can see it sticking through. I'll show you real quick how to get it to that halfway. Remember, it's 8.6. So I simply grabbed the handle and moved it anywhere, but then I typed negative 4.3 so that it lined up exactly at the halfway mark. The wall of my sphere is thin, so therefore I just added a cube. Notice I made it larger than the shape, so it's 7 by 3.5 by 6. You can drag these with the handles, but notice if you do that, these break. So by just typing in my numbers, I could modify these to get the exact shape I wanted. If you look at how far in this is, I did that for strength. If you wanted to make it less, if you type 3 right now, it bounces it back. But notice we would have a gap over here on this edge, and we'd have to move that back in to get it so it connects with the side of the sphere. I'm going to do Control Z to put those back because I did like my other measurements. And let's get this regrouped and ready to send to the 3D printer. I'm going to take these two and I'm going to just move them out away. Let's grab all of these parts and do Control G to group. Bingo, we've got the holes and we've got the shape. Once again, this would normally be the entire sphere. I just printed it this way because we get to see how the mechanisms look and it makes the project a little faster. Bouncing quickly to Bamboo Lab Studio, you can see I have brought in all the parts. My parts are aligned. I'm going to do Control A and make sure I'm using the bamboo strength, just because I'd like this to be a little bit stronger. If we slice the plate, notice it's only going to take about 30 minutes to print. We can simply hit Print Plate, double check our colors, and send it for printing. All right, so here are our printed parts. This is the sphere, ZDP made. This is my modified one that would be a hollow sphere later. All right, so that one is snapped in. Notice when it snaps in, these squeeze out automatically. So I'm going to pinch that one back a little bit. Now that one is snapped in. That side has went pretty well. I'm going to pinch this just a tiny bit. And bingo, we have got a snap together sphere. How cool is that? Now, once again, this is at the tiniest scale. If you build these larger, of course, they're easier to slide in. But as you can see, the mechanism does work. All right, so let's try it with the half sphere. Once again, squeezing it in. That side went pretty well. These pop out, so I'm going to try and get it pushed back. So it's ready for the other part. And of course, slide it in. Get them pinched a little bit back together. Holy cow. Snap fit parts. How cool is that? All right, so I am real pleased with those results. I'm looking forward to making other projects like this. Friends, as I wrap up, though, I want to mention paying it forward. ZDP was so cool to share this design with us. Friends, we can do the same thing for other people. When you are done with a project that you are pleased with, simply back up to the Tinkercad desktop. Your initial creations are all private, but if you make something that you think is fantastic or that you just want the world to see, you can hit Properties. Give it a better name, a description. Of course, mine is going to mention it has the tutorial. I just quickly added the template. Notice you can stretch this down further. I added tags, and the tag I want to highlight is the HLMT23 tag. Friends, whenever you add that tag, I will check out your design, and of course, I will give it a reaction. Finally, make your design public, and if you want people to be able to modify it, leave it as share alike. If you want people to only be able to see it, simply choose no derivatives. Of course, I want mine to be share alike, so I'm simply going to hit save changes. Notice they do make you prove you're not a robot. Once you do that, friends, your design will be visible in the gallery. The first time you click on the gallery, of course, you see all the staff picks. And of course, a few fantastic designs by ZDP189. Don't forget, you can click this link to see all of his designs. I do also want to highlight, if you get on a little further, you can find the fantastic Flexi Rexy. Of course, if you click on that design, the reactions are appreciated. Notice if you check up here, there is likely a tutorial as well. Friends, by simply adding that tag, I check this every day. Of course, I will check out your fantastic designs and give you a reaction. How cool is that? Friends, as I wrap up, huge shout out to ZDP for the original creation. I am also looking forward to seeing all the designs you create as well. Friends, I do want to wrap up by saying thank you to all my supporters of the YouTube channel. Of course, there are three different levels and all support is appreciated. Also, a huge shout out to the members of my Patreon. Love how that group is growing. The discussion area is amazing. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HL Mod Tech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.